Good evening, and welcome to a brand new episode of Monster Movie Night. I'm your internet horror host, Bobby Gamonster, along with my pal back there on the perch, Boris T. Buzzard. Welcome, one and all. Welcome, one and all. We here at the Gargoyle Manor, the Monster Museum, are always looking for new and interesting artifacts, objects, and films. I mean, after all, when you have an itch, what better to scratch that itch than a monster hand? And what better to scratch an itch for a new film than with a brand new film from a brand new wonderful filmmaker and director. That's right, from Norman Butt himself, comes Vampire Ticks from Outer Space. That's right, this time around we have a science fiction horror comedy from a newcomer that's been around for a while now, but yet new to us here at the Manor. And with a new film for us that he's allowing our show to show you, Vampire Ticks from Outer Space. What more could you ask for? Well, let's get started and let us go to Norman Butt's Vampire Ticks from Outer Space.
Everybody's crazy. Papa goes the weasel. Everybody knows the weasel blows. But popcorn, she pops real good. I eat popcorn. Everybody eats popcorn. She tastes real nice. Get yourself some now at our refreshment stand.
Frida! I got the tent from the car. You can come out and stop being mad at me now. Frida? Tell me to go and get the tent from the car, and I go and get the tent from the car, and leave you here, and where are you now? Frida! Frida! Guess I'll just set up the tent on my own. Yeah, hours and hours of work every time. Just gotta do it all. Every time. It sucks. Alright, go and get the 10. Last week, you were all like, go and get me some milk. That tent is dirty. Probably should have cleared it up before we left. We don't want to get any invasive species in the area. What was that? Hello? Rita, was that you? God, stupid weeds. I was brambling. Rita! I found your shoe! And it's broken! Wow! That looks like a shipping crate from outer space! What the heck are those?
It's been 4 years since I've been home. Almost starting to miss that smell. Farm country.
What happened to all my cows? What was that? What's that? Ah! 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 Ah!
I'll be there in half an hour. You have the money? Stick it in your boot. We're going to Vegas. You got your bag packed? Because I'm driving to pick you up, stupid. Of course I'm talking on the cell phone. If it were dangerous, people wouldn't be doing it. What the hell is that? This. Mom, Dad, I'm home. Mom? Yeah? Stay there. Hello? Mom? Dad? Guess they're not home. Nope, that's not a note. No diet. Come on. Almost more than one diet. And there's no signal here. Signal now. Nope. Is there a signal now? Nope. Is there a signal now? Nope. Is there a signal now? nothing much. I just, I'm home. And, the parents aren't here. You know, did they tell you anything?
No, nobody told me anything.
Well, I'm all alone. Would you mind coming over?
You want me to come over now?
Quite frankly, it's kind of spooky all alone. I'm getting one of my bad feelings.
All right, I'll be there in a little bit.
Yeah, well, thanks, bro. Yeah, see you soon. Bye.
Jeez, you're trying to look good for once.
Susan!
What?
Your car has been missing all day. No room for him.
Caller, I have a date in 10 minutes.
When are you going to the car? Susan!
My date, I'm so going to go.
Victim of the crazy killer who's coming to our campsite tonight.
Stop it!
Stop what, little sis?
You scared? You shouldn't be. Look at this tent. I mean, do you see this?
Yeah.
Nothing can get through that. Unless, of course, they have the Hulk!
Good job. Quit hashing the fire.
Look out! Ah!
What? You almost hit a turtle.
What? The Hulk!
Box.
Get off me, you little... Oh, no, you don't! Oh, gross. Oh, yuck.
Quiet, bro. Ixnay on the legal A, compadre.
You said you knew the people who own this land.
Listen, Frida? Babe, this is public land.
Are you down there?
Well, if the cops show up,
is that your light?
Explain what we're doing here. Ah, for once, I should have listened to Mother.
Fear is to...
Ouch!
You're not fooling me this time, Johnny.
Wendy! Help me! Ah!
I'm leaving.
It's got my arm! It's got my arm!
Ah! John?
Ah! Ah!
Johnny, stop it! You're not fooling anyone. I mean it.
Help me!
Chill, babe. There's no one here.
Already fine, but if we get caught...
Shit! Help!
What?
Help!
What is this?
Big!
What's going on?
Big!
Look at that!
Hey! Hey, come here, little guy!
Hey, and there's more!
Oh, and even more!
Big kill Johnny! Look,
car!
Just a little alien that tried to kill you.
Oh God.
Jeez, lady.
What the heck are you doing out there dressed like that during a full-scale invasion?
I am having the worst day of my life right now. Please just leave me alone.
You're having your worst day? I just killed an alien like 5 minutes ago, and now I get attacked by a woman dressed like a kabuki!
Well, I just got attacked by radioactive mutants.
So how's the rest of your day going? Take care of me!
Ow! Close that door. Well, I'm 99% sure there isn't a single tick left alive in this basement.
Here!
Louie! Oh!
anything.
There's somebody out here, man.
Who?
Jed, get in the house!
Get back in the house, man!
Get in the house now!
Get back in the car!
Get in the house now! Don't listen to him! Get in the house! The aliens are outside! You gotta get in here now!
Get in the house!
Get in here, aliens!
Radiation.
Huh? Growth hormones, man. I mean, look what they're doing to us.
Get in here now!
Can't hear you when you're all talking at the same time. Don't understand. Woo!
What an interesting film. I mean, really, it's got me on the edge of my feet. I mean, and after all, with a film like that, that's similar or reminiscent of the old B movies of the 50s, you have to have your popcorn. And here at the Gargoyle Manor, the Monster Museum, our popcorn comes from outer space itself with killer clowns, no less, from outer space. And this little fellow here comes in his own little popcorn tin, as you can see, and he's just dying to eat up anybody that's trying to steal his popcorn. This is a sort of reminiscent of tonight's film a little bit. I mean, this fellow was from outer space. The ticks are vampires from outer space. Not your normal, everyday, run-of-the-mill vampires, that is. Tick vampires. Big ones. Just ready to latch on, suck and suck and suck until they get so big and just, you know, you just want to take your walking stick like Nightmare here and go, pow, pop them real good, you know? Make the blood splatter that much better. Anyway, okay. So you're going to share your popcorn with me? No, you're not? Okay. You're not going to share it with Boris back there either, huh? No? Well, that, we'll have to see about that. Anyway, let's go back to Vampire Ticks from Outer Space.
Thanks for coming, Jed.
Your brother. I always got your back. Want me to tell me what's going on?
Has anyone called the police yet?
No. You gotta climb the barn to get a signal and the regular phone is out.
Alright, well, if you do get a signal, don't mention aliens again.
Just let that go.
You're that nut.
Hey, yeah, you're the guy on the internet.
The aliens are gonna hold us.
The aliens are gonna hold us.
You doing okay?
Hell no.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Spent half my life looking for aliens, looking for proof. Now they got me trapped inside a house.
Excuse me, I just found my dead boyfriend outside in the woods when I was running around trying to find my father because my mom was harping on and on about trying to find him. We were gonna go to Vegas and get married, and all you can think about is finding proof of your stupid aliens. God. Just forget it. I don't want to talk about it right now.
Yeah. There's, relax, there's no way they can get in here.
They're in the basement!
There's nothing down here.
Whoa. Maybe there is.
Okay. They're in the basement. What we have to do is we have to get some weapons and we have to get out of here. So, let's all do that. I'm gonna find my brother.
We can't leave the house! People always die when they leave the house in the movies.
Not in the remakes.
Oh yeah, she survived in that one.
Hey, idiots! We're talking about stupid old horror movies while there are monsters outside!
I went down to get some enchilada sauce. They're in the basement now.
That's probably it.
I'd argue, but my brother has no sense of direction.
Look out, deer!
Look out for what, pumpkin?
Just put a grill guard on the thing.
Mother! The deer went underneath it.
You guys all right back there?
Yeah, we're all right.
Man, when they say you should always wear your seatbelt, they mean you should always wear your seatbelt.
Understand. Weren't they ahead of us?
Maybe they went somewhere else?
Unlikely. He knows this is where we go in case of an emergency.
Like what?
Like the nuclear plant going critical. I come from a paranoid family, okay?
Obviously.
Wait. I left my Lucky Rabbit's foot back in the car. We've got to go back for it.
Sit down, shut up, and don't make any noise!
Ideas?
No.
Do you want us to think of some? Wait, what about,
the van? No way.
No.
Take it, because Johnny has the keys.
Wait, when Mikey and Susie get there, won't they send for some help, right?
How come there are no ticks jumping out the windows? Where'd they all go?
So do you, like, always stare out the window?
They should be here by now. Where are they?
Okay, last time you said that they showed up 5 minutes later.
I know, this is different. I just have a different feeling. Cell phone. With signal. Should have called.
Well, maybe they were somewhere where they didn't have coverage.
At the house.
What?
They're back at the house.
Okay, you were jumping to way too many conclusions.
I have a feeling they're back at the house. We gotta go get them.
Are you crazy? There are ticks out there.
Well, not that many.
Plus, your car only seats 4, and is full of junk.
Fine.
Have fun.
I'm sorry to bother you, my dear, but your mascara is running.
Hey, Pumpkin, there's a wrench over here. We could use this for a weapon.
Sounds good.
Wait, I bet this is why rednecks keep guns around. What?
His name is Jed. his brother thinks he saw aliens, let's not insult them.
You drive slower than your grandma, and I have proof.
Susan?
Mm-hmm.
How did you get here?
Your grandma gave me a ride. Hey, can we stop at the gun store?
What for?
To buy guns.
I'd love to do that, but where are we going to get the fundage? Where did you get that?
Oh, I was gonna use it to elope with my boyfriend. But then I realized he was a pussy. And a jerk. And he's dead. And I think I was just with him to piss off my parents.
He was a jerk and a pussy?
Hard to believe, but yeah, he was.
Oh, those two traits don't go together.
Thank you.
Where the heck are all the ticks? Johnny.
Oh, down by the spaceship.
The spaceship?
Did I forget to mention that?
Keys. Gotta find keys. Oh, we gotta find keys.
Thank you. Explorer 1 to Mission Control. Explorer 1 to Mission Control. This is Mission Control reading you loud and clear, Explorer 1. What's your situation? I have confirmation of an invasive species on this planet. Fitting the description of the lost crate we are searching for, please advise.
Explorer 2 to Mission Control. Explorer 2 to Mission Control. Found the crate. They're all around me. Get me out of here.
Hold on, Explorer 2. We're getting you out now. This is your captain speaking. I want all units to return to the ship. Explorer teams, prepare for evacuation.
Yes, ma'am.
And someone get me a line to the president now.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Right away.
When he hears about this, he's gonna release the killer robots.
Mr. President?
Ah, thank you, little robot man. Take this call. Hello, President of the Galaxy. Speaking.
Mr. President, we have a situation here.
Well, I got a situation here, too. It's called papers. I got to sign them.
Mr. President, do you remember that crate of Naborian blood beasts you ordered?
No, I do not. Therefore, it must be someone else's crate. Just stop looking for it.
Mr. President, I'm asking for clearance to reverse time in this sector. Will you grant it?
Why would I grant something that doesn't even exist? It doesn't make much sense, especially since it's close to an election year.
Mr. President?
Yeah?
Remember what happened between us during the last Lunar Festival? Who would it be worse to tell? Your wife or the press?
Time clearance granted. Don't pull that on me again.
I won't, Mr. President. Have a good day. Attention all crew, prepare yourself with memory intact helmets. We are preparing to go back in time. Activate the Alpha 14.
Jed. Yeah, I'm coming home. I love you too. Say, Jed, never mind. Yeah. Bye. He doesn't remember. No one remembers. But I know it wasn't a dream. It couldn't have been a dream. My tacit's missing.
Alright, telling me to go and put up a tent. I'll put up a tent. Put up a tent like you wouldn't believe. Put up two tents. Show her. Put up a tent. Oh man, this tent is dirty.
No, I don't think that's a good idea. Well, maybe I don't want to elope anymore. You are such a jerk! And a pussy! Dad!
Look at all my beautiful cows!
This is Tom Lewis on campus of the university in Athens, Georgia, and about to speak to Professor Bauer, who has reported sighting a UFO. Professor Bauer, exactly what happened?
On the way home, my car stopped, stalled on the road there, and I got out to check to see how anything I could do to fix it, what was wrong, and this strong blast of wind just threw me up against the side of the car. A few seconds later, when I could see, I saw this object pass over. Moving rather slowly, but very positively powered. I'd say it had a disc-like look to it, but, you know, it's reflecting light. It's hard to see clear. But it was very definitely an object other than a, you know, reflection or a balloon or something.
What do you think this means in the whole scope of things, the whole universe?
Well, I think there's no doubt about it, that somewhere, somehow, we're being visited by extraterrestrial bodies and visiting our planet and maybe looking it over.
Mrs. Acree, you have reported sighting an unidentified flying object.
And I called the yard man's attention to it. So he looked at it, and he said that he thought it was a weather balloon, that it couldn't be an airplane because it was moving too slowly.
How fast, really, would you say that it was moving?
Well, it was moving very slow at that time. But then he said that it was not a helicopter because it was making no noise. So it would have to be a weather balloon.
Did the speed of the object stay the same or did it change directions or speed?
About that time that it suddenly turned and sailed across the sky very fast. Then it stopped and just stood still in the sky, just hovered there. And slowly began moving over towards us.
Miss Acree, what do you think that you actually saw? What do you feel you saw at this
time? I just have no idea what this thing was. I've never seen anything like it before. So it must be non-identifying object, flying saucer that we hear about.
I understand something strange happened to you folks while you were here last night.
Yeah, that's true. That thing came up, and it moved really fast, and came right over us and hovered right over us and picked us up. And it was just it was a rush of air. It picked both of us up. It's like being on an elevator, but no elevator. You know what I mean? It just lifted us up and then put us down on a metal table. And before we had time to think about anything or look around, there was this voice that kind of inside of you that said, "Calm, you know, be calm and don't worry about anything." And at the same time,
this voice, now, what, it spoke in English?
No, you just knew something inside. It wasn't going to hurt you. It said just to lay there and no harm would ever come to
it's
us.
Like you weren't hearing anything at all. And it was just inside of you.
And we just knew we were still scared, but we weren't as scared as we were.
Well, the day it happened, Sam and I were out working the cattle. I rode down to this point and looked right up there, and I saw this object just sitting there. And I called Sam, and he rode over right quick. And this thing just sat there, and we both looked at it, and about that time it shot up about 5,000 or 6,000 feet in the air and then shot over that way. Sam, how big do you think it was?
I would say 30 to 40 feet, cigar-shaped. We heard a screaming whine. And the closer to the top of the hill we got, the louder it got, and then we heard this explosion.
All right, this is where the plane crashed. You can see it looked like it came down toward my lake, then went up, and then looked like something just forced it right down into this hillside. It just cut off the trees and just disintegrated, and just the wreckage you can see right here just scattered everywhere.
Then it looked like the plane just dropped very quickly.
Right.
We feel that since there was no really probe into this crash, that and there has been several UFO sightings in this area for some time now, that well, we know what we saw.
Well, Boris, do you enjoy the film? I mean, after all those ticks from outer space and latching on to all those young people, I'm telling you, that Norman Butt, he really knows how to make a film, right? Just like the old B movies, horror comedy, science fiction. I see great things in his future, don't you, Boris? And I'm so glad. We want to thank him once more and thank all the actors in this film as well for making the film, for him directing and making the film, and for them acting in the film, and then he allowing us here at Monster Movie Night for showing it so that you guys out there can enjoy the film as well, right? I mean, here at we're here at the Manor, we're always looking for something special, right, Boris? To treat you with, to entreat you with, to lure you in, maybe, as it were, to get the drop on you. Maybe make a new exhibit. You never know. Well, anyway, thank you for coming. So glad that you could enjoy the film with us. So glad that you could be here with us in our home. And hope that you'll come back next time for another thrilling, chilling episode of Monster Movie Night. I'll be your internet horror host, Bobby the Monster, along with Boris T. Buzzard. And until next time, keep screaming.